Hello friends, hope you all are doing great. Today's class 7 is all about introduction to weight management. Today I'm going to give some basic important points which are related to weight science and will continue further. So let us start our session. The first one is define weight. The weight is nothing but plant which is out of place. There are many definitions which are related to weight, but the most common and simple definition is plant which is out of place. Some people say unwanted plant, undesirable plant, but unwanted plant, for example, if you are raising rice crop, in rice crop if we get wheat plant, can we consider it is an unwanted plant? No, we cannot say wheat is an unwanted plant. But the plant which is out of place, that means in rice, if plant wheat plant comes, that is actually useful plant, but it is coming in out of place. So that's the reason they define weed is a plant which is out of place, where actually it needs to be there only. If it is misplaced or came in the place which is not supposed to be, that we call weed. So plant which is out of place. Then the next one is, the first person to use the word weed is Jethro Tull. In the previous class, I have said about Jethro Tull who termed weed. Then let us see, define herbicide. Herbicide is a chemical substance which can kill, destroy or suppress the weeds is called herbicide. It may be any chemical substance or agent used to destroy or inhibit the plant growth. Then the first herbicide used is copper sulfate. This is very, very important blank. The first herbicide which was used is copper sulfate in the year 1821, very long ago, in the name of blue vitriol, BLUEVITRIOL, blue vitriol. The first herbicide invented and patented by John E. Frange. So this one is the first herbicide actually they used, but officially invented and patented herbicide is glyphosate, which is non-systemic herbicide. As classes moves further, I'll explain what is the meaning of the classification of herbicides, in fact. Okay, this was introduced by John E. Frange. This is one of the scientists who know about the plant physiology and also who did study in plant biochemistry for 1 year, and he introduced glyphosate, and this glyphosate he was patented. That means that whatever he has invented, he took permission from the government that he is the author of that particular herbicide. So this herbicide for $5 bought by Monsanto company. Hope you all know the company Monsanto. It is one of the leading multinational company in agriculture, which is American based company. This company bought this glyphosate herbicide from John E. Frange for just $5. So in the year 1970 they bought, and into the market they released in the year 1974. So this is one of the important blank. The first patented herbicide is glyphosate, which was invented by John E. Frange and bought by Monsanto and released into the market in the year 1974. The chemical name of the glyphosate is 2-methyl-4-6-dinitrophenol. 2-methyl-4-6-dinitrophenol. Then the next point. First biologically controlled weed is Lantana camara. The first biologically controlled weed is Lantana camara. There are different, especially 4 types of weed control methods are there. So among which one of the method is biological control and other method is chemical control. So from biological control, by using insects or parasites, whatever it may be, by using that they control, the first weed is Lantana camara. This is one of the important plant. Then next one is, in agriculture we are having different losses due to weeds, due to pest, due to disease or any other. So among all these, weeds are the thing which causing the great damage to the agriculture crops. That is around 45%, up to 45% loss can be done by only weeds. Then by through pest 30%, through disease 20%, and others 5%. So at max is by weeds. So this is also very important blanks. So blank. Then the next one is types of weeds. They are grasses, sedges and broad-leaved weeds. So in short form we call BLW, broadleaf weeds. So based on their appearance or phenology, they distinguish it into three types: grasses, sedges and broadleaf weeds. So grasses means, hope you know, the plants which are having nodes and internodes can be considered as grass. See, for example, if you see the rice plant, rice also is having nodes and internodes. Rice plant also comes under grass. So the weeds which are having nodes and internodes all comes under grass, and the sedges which are not having any node or internode, for example, cypress, rotundus. Then the next one is broad-leaved weeds. So for broad-leaved weeds, in the name itself, it shows the leaves which are widened, like Datura, even Lantana camara. These are the plants which are having broad leaves. They all comes under broad-leaved weeds. So these are the three types based on phenology, we can say. So weeds are classified into three. Then the next one is cypress rotundus. This is one of the very noxious weed, or a very that weed which can reproduce by seeds, by tubers, or however it may be, it will come very, very noxious way. That's why they named it as world worst weed. So world worst weed is cypress rotundus. World worst weed is cypress. Then the next one is allelopathy. The word allelopathy is derived from Greek. The meaning of allelopathy is mutual harm or suffering. Mutual harm or suffering. The definition of allelopathy is any chemical substance which is produced by one plant and which will affect on other plant, which may kill or suppress the growth of the other plant, is called allelopathy. I am repeating, any chemical substance which is produced by one plant which will cause effect, which may kill or suppress the other plant, is called allelopathy. So in allelopathy we are having different types. So true allelopathy or functional allelopathy. In the upcoming classes I'll explain in detail on this particular concept. This allelopathy was first given by Hans Molisch in the year 1937 in the book called Allelopathy, The Effect of Plants on Each Other. This was released in 2010, but he has given this word in the year 1937. Then next one is weed seed bank. So soil is called weed seed bank because weeds are having one of the special character called the prolific weeds seeds. That means each plant can produce hundreds of weeds, even thousands of weed seeds. So those seeds will be remain in the soil. That's why soil will act as weed seed bank. So next season, one plant if it produce some thousand weed seeds, the same seeds will come in the next season. That means one plant can become thousand plants in the next season. So till then, those seeds will be in the soil. So soil is acting as a bank. That's why they named it as soil is a weed seed bank. Then the next one is parasitic weed. What is the meaning of parasitic weed? Parasitic weed means any plant which is depending on the other plant. That plant we called host plant, and weed called parasitic. So any plant which is depending on the host plant for its growth and development, it may depend partially or it may depend completely. So if it is depending completely, that we call complete parasite. If it is depending on partially, that we call partially parasitic weed. So any plant which is depending on the other plant for its growth and development is called parasitic weed. It may be for the nutrients, it may be for the water, any other. So in this parasitic weed also there is a classification, four types are there, that also I'll explain in upcoming classes on this particular topic specially. Then the next one is mimicry weed. Mimicry weed is something like the weed which will mimic as such other plant. That means, for example, I myself is there, I am a crop plant, and like crop plant, another weed is there which also can resemble or appear as like me. That's it. That is actually weed. We cannot identify whether it is crop or weed. That's called mimicry weed. So in rice crop, what is the mimicry weed? Echinoclava colonum. So Echinoclava colonum is the mimicry weed in rice crop. If it is in the wheat, fallow is minor. Likewise, we are having mimicry weed just the resemble like crop. So these weeds we can know after when they give the reproductive part, then only we can differentiate whether that is a crop plant or weed plant. Then the next one is alien weed. The other name of alien weed is exotic weed. So for some of the weeds which has come from other countries to our country, those weeds we call alien weeds or exotic weeds. So for example, what do we call Parthenium histophorus. Parthenium histophorus is the one of the weed which has come from other country. Other name is carrot grass, commonly we call carrot grass or Congress weed. So this one is also called asthma. Okay, this one also cause asthma to the human being. This is also one of the very dangerous weed. So in everywhere in India this weed has come. This is one of the weed which has come out of the country. That's we call exotic weed or alien weed. Then the next one is dormancy. What is the meaning of dormancy? Dormancy is nothing but the resting stage of the seed. So weed seeds are having very good character of dormancy. That means they can be in the soil years together. See, when we plow the soil, the topmost layer of the soil will go to the next layer of the soil. So when it goes, the topmost layer of the soil in that, what are the seeds which are present in the topmost layer, they also will go to the deeper layers of the soil where they cannot germinate. So years together they'll be in the soil. So as years pass by, when we are plowing again, lowermost layer of the soil will come up. So when it comes again, they can germinate. So wheat seeds are having very good dormancy. They can undergo dormancy for years together. In dormancy also we are having three types, that also I'll explain in the further classes. So these are the few basic and definitions are the important points which are related to weed management. Thank you so much. In the upcoming classes I'll be explaining the topic wise in detail. So if you like this class, please like the video and please share with your friends, and if you don't subscribe, please do subscribe. Thank you.